Hello, good morning everybody. While I was making the roguelike series, I found a few problems with the pathfinding. The paths are weird, the enemies can't detect other enemies, and the movement doesn't look natural. So I will make some videos about aesthetic behaviors, a way to make the characters aware of their surroundings. In this video, we will implement the seek and avoid obstacles behaviors. Let's get on with this. We will start with the seek behavior, the most simple. We will apply a force to move the velocity vector to face the target position. Open your character script and add a new vector2 variable, call it velocity, and store the maximum velocity of the character in a variable with the name maxSpeed. Also, store the maximum steering in a variable too. It has to be small because we will be adding the steering to the velocity every frame. Create a function called seekSteering that returns a vector2. First, we calculate the desired velocity, the direction to the target. In this case, the mouse multiplied by the maximum speed. We return the seekSteering, the vector that goes from the velocity to the desired velocity. Now, in the physicsProcess function, create a variable called steering and initialize it to a zero vector. We will add all the steerings to this variable. For the moment, add the seekSteering to it. After adding all the steerings, clamp the variable to the maximum steering we defined earlier. Add the steering to the velocity and clamp the velocity with the maximum speed variable. Finally, move the character using the move and slide function with the velocity as a parameter. Play the game. The character follows the mouse, but he doesn't change direction instantly. Instead, he does it smoothly. But if we go to a rock, we can collide with it. So to fix this, we have to implement the avoid obstacles steering. Add a node 2D in your character scene and instance the recast as a shield into it. Make it face the right and enable it. Add two more raycasts inside the node, one above and one below. This raycast will detect the obstacles. The distance between them determines the separation to the obstacle. The bigger the distance between raycasts, the bigger the separation. Back at the character script, create a variable called avoidForce to determine the tendency of the player to avoid obstacles. I want to give priority to avoid the obstacles, so I initialize the variable to 1000. Also, add an onReady variable for the node2D that contains all the raycasts. Create a new function with the name avoidObstaclesSteering that returns a vector2. This function will return the corresponding steering. First of all, rotate the raycast container to face the same direction as the velocity. Iterate over the raycast and update his length to match the velocity vector. The length of the raycast can be modified using the cast to x value of the raycast. If the raycast is colliding, store the object in a variable and return the normalized vector, multiplied by the void force that goes from the obstacle to the velocity vector plus the character position. This way, the faster the character goes, the bigger the raycast range. And if the velocity is very high and the character is near an obstacle, his speed will decrease. If none of the raycasts collide, return a zero vector. To apply the new steering, just add it to the steering variable in the physicsProcess function. Let's test the new steering. If you want to see the raycast collisions, you have to enable the visible collision shapes. Play the game. And now the player dodges the rocks. Thanks for watching. I want to send a special thanks to Bestie for making the art. Thanks, bro, you are the best. And that's all for today. Until the next video.